You launching ads with our pixel! That's like flying a plane without any wings! You're burning cash and Meta's AI is flying blind! In this video, I'll show you how to find out if your pixel is missing, how to fix it, and why it's the single most important piece of your ad setup! What's going on, gang? It's your boy Derry the Advertiser coming back at you with a brand new video! And today, I'm going to be uncovering the truth that most advertisers when they're starting out don't realize! No pixel means no data, means no better ad results! And if not set up properly, it's the number one reason your Meta ads burn budget with nothing to show for it. Good news, guys. Fixing this is simple and it can turn a failing ad account to one that actually learns, optimizes, and scales. So stick around, guys. We're going to get into it today. So, guys, by the end of today, you will learn how to quickly diagnose if your pixel is missing, exact steps to install your pixel while via the Meta Events Manager, why the pixel is the foundation to ad optimization, and how it cuts wasted ad spend, and finally, how to confirm your pixel is firing correctly before you launch your campaigns. So guys, grab your coffees and grab your hats. It's time to spin up some ad magic. Woo! Okay guys, first step that we need to do, and I advise everybody to do this, if you're thinking about running ads or not, okay, what we can do is we can install an extension to our browser. If you're using Chrome, Safari, Brave, whatever your browser, make sure that you have this Meta Pixel Helper installed as an extension on your browser, okay? So just type in Meta Pixel Helper, click the first link, okay? It's this one here. You can add it to your browser up here. And when it's installed, it'll appear as a little icon in the top corner here, as you can see, okay? And what this tool does is it gives you an insight as to whether or not the pixel is installed in the first place and the conversion events that are firing as you're navigating through the website. So super, super cool to get this because it gives you a diagnosis tool as to what is happening on your website for your Meta Pixel. So that's step number one, guys. Make sure that this is installed on your browser. Then, guys, what you want to do is you want to navigate to the website that you are trying to diagnose. Does this website have a pixel or not? Then, using the Meta Pixel Helper, when you click on here, it will tell you the diagnosis of this current website. With this current website, there is no pixel. As you can see there, no pixel found on this website. Now, guys, I'm going to show you an example of a website where it has been installed, okay? So on this one, what we can see here is a little one to indicate that something has fired over into Meta. And if you click on this, doesn't matter if you're admin to the website or not, you can do this on any single website. You can see if the website has a pixel installed behind it, okay? And as you can see here, there's an event that has fired, which is page view, okay? When somebody lands on the page. Conversion event page view gets fired and gets sent back into Meta, right? So it can learn and optimize. This is what it will look like when you do have a pixel installed. As you can see here, it says one pixel found, right? So that's step number one, guys. Go and diagnose whether or not you have a pixel installed. If you or your client or the business that you're going to be working with has a pixel installed already, okay, go and diagnose this. If not, we will proceed to the next step, guys, because if there isn't a pixel there, we need to go and add on to the website. So how do we do that, guys? Well, we need to navigate into the Meta Ad Manager. And here on the left-hand side, we're going to navigate to a place called the Events Manager. This is one of my favorite places in the Meta Ad Manager system, okay? Go here. This is where you will find everything to do with your pixel, everything to do with your conversions. It will be here in the Events Manager. So we're going to go to Events Manager. We're going to click on this, and then it's going to bring us to a window where we can select that we want to view. It will list all of the different pixels on this page. If you don't have a pixel installed here, what it will do is it will bring up a window where it will say, you need to set up this pixel. You need to set this up, and I'm going to go through the steps that you'll expect to see there. Now, if you have a pixel already and it's broken, or if you have a pixel and you want to add it to a new website, how do you do that? Well, it's the same process as adding a new pixel for the first time. Now, one, if you go to the Events Manager and you haven't got anything set up here, it will tell you here to go and set your pixel up, and then it will give you instructions on how to do that. If you do already have a pixel installed, you will see the pixel data display here. And exactly the same process, we're going to press Manage Integrations on the right-hand side in order to install that pixel, okay? Even if you want to install the pixel on a new website, this is how you do that, right? You always install the pixel via this method, if you've got a new pixel or an old pixel. Right, you go to Manage Integrations to install your pixel. Then you choose the pixel that which you want to install. This Meta Pixel one here, you're going to press Manage, and you're going to press Install Pixel on New Websites, right? Then it's going to say, hey, do you want to add the code manually, or do you want to use a partner integration? If you are hosting your website on a common platform like WordPress, Shopify, Wix, check for the partners in which you can partner, because you can install the Meta Pixel directly without needing to install anything manually. It's a check for the partner, select the software that you're using, and it will tell you the step-by-step actions needed to install your pixel there, right? So for here, for Kajabi, it gives you step-by-step instructions of where you need to go to install the pixel on that platform, right? So you can install your pixel on different platforms as well. Okay, guys? But for this, what we're going to do is we're going to install the code manually. Okay, well, we're going to get the code and we're going to send the code to the developer, right? Because the developer is going to add the code in. Okay, if you have access to the website, then you can do this as well. Very, very simply, okay, go into the website settings. And what I'd suggest is if you want to know how to install your pixel on the specific website platform that you're using, type it into Google. So what I've done here is I've typed in WordPress, the website that we're installing on, then where the code will go, and then the word pixel, right? And it's given me here how to install the pixel on WordPress, okay? Where to go to this head section to add the pixel code in. Okay, so go and research. If you don't know where to add this code, if you don't have a developer, you'll need to go and research this yourself. If you do have a developer, they will know where to add this code. So we're going to press it, install code manually. It's going to bring us the step-by-step. We're going to leave all of the automatic advanced matching on. This is the different data that is tracking. We're going to press next, and then we're going to press go to pixel. But before we go anywhere else, Annie New here. Don't forget to hit that like and subscribe.
Don't forget to hit that notification bell so you never miss any more important updates.
We are here many times a week to help business owners and advertising digital marketeers to the best from the online advertising, peer media, and digital marketing strategies.
But without further ado, let's get on with the video.
Okay, so when you go to add your pixel, the first thing that you will be brought to is this install your base code. This is your pixel code, guys. The pixel tracks all data. If you don't have a pixel, then Meta can't see what's happening on your website. So that's why it's super, super, super important to have your Meta pixel installed. And in order to do that, what you want to do is you want to copy the code here. And then there it says, add the base code to your website header. You want to send this code that you've just copied to your developer in an email to say, hey, can you add this above the head tag on the website, right? And you don't need to add the pixel on every single page. You just add it in once, and then every single page on the website is automatically tracked. Super, super cool. Now Meta has the pixel data on the website. It can see everything that's happening on the website, right? Then once you go to continue, leave the automatic advanced matching turned on. This is the type of data that it's collecting, okay? And then go to next, and then here we can also add events, right? We can add the events using the event setup tool. This is in the video on how to do that. If you want to know how to add conversions using the Meta event setup tool, I'll link a card in the top corner so you know how to set up your conversion events using this event setup tool. But then you go to the pixel, and then the Meta ads manager will change. It will start seeing this graph whereby you'll see the data starting coming through from where you have installed your pixel, aka your website. Okay, so now we have our pixel installed. Meta can see everything that's going on the website. Something to bear in mind, guys, if you don't see this come up straight away, or you've added a conversion event and it doesn't come up straight away, what I would highly recommend is waiting 30 minutes. Okay, it is advised that sometimes the data doesn't get populated straight away. Go make a coffee, take a sip back, and wait 30 minutes, and then go check the events manager again in the Meta ads manager. And at that point, hopefully you'll see the data coming through, right? So if you don't see it straight away, don't panic, guys. Just wait half an hour and then go and check it again. Hopefully you'll see that data coming through. If you want to test this, guys, again, like I said, the Meta Pixel Helper will tell you whether or not a pixel is firing here. But another way to test this is one of my other favorite areas in this particular section of the Events Manager is the Test Events section. You're going to click here after you set up your pixel. If you want to make sure everything is also firing correctly, go to Test Events, go down to the bottom here where it says confirm that your website events are set up correctly. Type in the landing page or your homepage URL and then press confirm. And what it will do is it'll open up the website. And then when you go back to the event Events Manager in the other tab, it will show you that the pixel is firing. We can see receiving activity and one of the conversion events, that is, which is a page view, which is just somebody landing on the landing page. This page view will get fired on any page that someone visits so that Meta can see that data and see how they're interacting with your business, okay? So really, really good. Now, guys, I just want to go through why this is so important and just to highlight and to drive this point home for you guys, right? Like I said, without a pixel, it's like flying a plane without the wings. It's very, very much about the inputs and outputs needed to train our ad AI than it is with us tinkering with the controls and telling the ad system where to go. And this is why this is important, because as you have a pixel on your website, Meta can slowly start to learn about the behaviors of your users and the website traffic of how they are engaging with the website. Okay, so now that we have the pixel installed, like I said, what you also want to do is you want to train your Meta ad AI where conversions are happening. So when someone makes a purchase, when someone submits the lead details to contact you, okay, you want to tell Meta, hey, there is something of significance to the business that's happened here. And when somebody reaches that,
That is a successful conversion, a successful purchase, etc. Right? And that conversion data then gets fired back into the Meta Pixel. Now, if you've optimized a campaign around a certain action, like purchase, once people go through the purchase journey and start triggering that purchase event, Meta will learn who is getting to that stage and find other people likely to get to that purchase event stage. Okay, so it's very much about Meta's AI and how we can train it to find good results. Okay, and guys, Meta has so much information about his audience. They call them audience signals. Okay, so Meta knows a lot about its users. It knows who's likely to take action and not. If we can train our Meta ad manager with the ad AI, then the ad AI is going to learn and find us other results that also drive impact. This is why the pixel and conversion events ad AI training best practice is super, super important, guys. Okay, if you don't have this stuff installed, Meta can't learn. Okay, like I said, it's like flying a plane without the wings. Meta can't see anything. It won't know what to optimize around. It won't know where user drop-off is. It won't be able to optimize around things that are happening. If Meta can see somebody's adding something to their cart, for example, and that person doesn't go to make the full purchase, and we're not logging that on our Meta Pixel, then Meta can't learn who's dropping off at the add to cart stage. How can I not target those people and target other people who are going to go and finish the purchase? Okay, we don't want just people adding to cart. So then if we train our ad AI around the purchase event, not just the add to cart, okay, it's going to find us other people who are likely to make a purchase. Like I said, Meta ad AI system knows who's likely to make purchase, and it will feed our ads to those people likely to take action. So like I keep saying, it's a lot more about the inputs and outputs needed to train our ad AI than it is with us tinkering with the controls. And this is a primary example of that, guys. Meta Pixel, super, super important to have this set up to make sure it's firing correctly and to ensure that it's driving that data back into Meta so that it can learn and feed you better results over time as more conversions come in. Typically, it does say that Meta requires 50 conversions to optimize and come out of the learning phase. This is very dependent on what it is you're selling and the value of that, but those numbers interchange a lot. So if you're wondering, guys, okay, about the data around how the ad AI system learns around the conversions, when you have an active campaign running, what I would recommend doing is hovering over where it says results, hovering over the campaign that you're looking at to get a breakdown of the results even further, right? So here we're optimizing for website purchases, as you can see, but what it does is it also gives you the breakdown of all the other conversion actions that have happened before somebody reaches that purchase. Okay, so as you can see here, so we had 190 add to carts, then we had 129 people initiate the checkout, and then we had 30 people purchase, right? So there we can see the drop-off. Meta can see that drop-off. Meta can learn who's adding to cart, who's initiating that checkout, who's going all the way to purchase. So it can find us other people likely to purchase and not likely to add to cart or any of the other things that don't actually move the needle for us, guys. So this is also why it's super important to set up your ad AI training and why it's super important for the Meta Pixel to be set up properly. Don't forget, guys, with that ad AI training, every conversion that you get only sharpens that AI to bring you more of those results. So that's why the ad AI training is hyper important now in the Meta Ads Manager. Give me a comment down below if you got any questions. Guys, if you want to learn what the Ad Wizard team has coming up next and you want to join the waitlist today to signal your attendant interest, click the link down below if you want to. No pressure at all, guys. If you want to find out what the Ad Wizard team has coming up next, click the link down below to join the waitlist today. Thank you so much. I appreciate every single one of you. And that's everything, guys. Hopefully now you have a really good understanding as to the major importances of the Meta Pixel, how to see if you set one up, how to fix it if not, and how to test to ensure it's firing correctly. So guys, hit me a comment down below if you got any questions. I'm your boy Jerry the Ad Wizard. You can find me on Instagram and X at Jerry Ad Wizard, on LinkedIn at Jerry Griffiths, and at Jerry Dreadlocks everywhere. If you want to watch a video on how to learn how to maximize your Meta Pixel to harmonize with your Meta Ad AI, fine tune and get you even better ad results, click this video over here. I've got a step-by-step walkthrough where we go through this. Guys, thank you so much. I appreciate every single one of you. I'm your boy Joe the Ad Wizard, and wherever you are in the world, I bid you peace and love and a wonderful rest of your day. And as always, I'll catch you in the next one.